13 मार्च 2021 से नेट फॉर इंडिया की रजिस्ट्रार के तौर पर मान्यता समाप्त होने जा रही है। एज पर द टर्मिनेशन नोटिस इश्यूड बाय ICNN टू नेट फॉर इंडिया ऑन 26 फरवरी 2021, नेट फॉर इंडिया लिमिटेड रजिस्ट्रार एक्रेडिटेशन एग्रीमेंट विद ICNN इज टर्मिनेटेड एंड द टर्मिनेशन शैल बिकम इफेक्टिव 13 मार्च 2021, 15 calendar days from the date of this termination notice. And what is the reason behind this termination? The termination is due to Net for India's repeated and consistent breaches of its agreement with ICNN and failure to cure such breaches despite several notices from ICNN and opportunity to cure it. So, what it means for you? If you are also one of the registrants who are facing problems due to non-functioning of their domains with Net for India. Upon the termination of Net for India's agreement with ICANN, the registrations done by Net for India must be transitioned to a competent accredited registrar. Usually, such transitions can be done through a bulk transfer. This bulk transfer requires sharing of the domain names and other registration data that will be affected by the transition process from the losing, that means de-accredited registrar, to ICANN. In this case, Net for India will be the losing or de-accredited registrar. However, being the sole source of registration data, ICANN seeks a good cooperation from the de-accredited registrar for a smooth transition. Based on the response from Net for India, there may be two possibilities. Number one, if Net for India will be cooperative and ready to share the registration data with a new registrar, ICNN may permit it to designate a gaining registrar to receive a bulk transfer of its domain names. This method generally involves least amount of friction and expedites the transition process. This process will be a voluntary bulk transfer, and approval of it by ICNN may depend on some of the following points, like whether the gaining registrar is in good condition with its ICNN obligations, whether the gaining registrar is operational and experienced in managing the affected domains, whether the gaining registrar is having a relationship with losing registrar that would hamper the proposed bulk transfer process. On the other hand, ICNN will also ensure whether the losing registrar would continue to manage the registrations as a reseller for the gaining registrar or involved in management of the names and customers that could affect the obligations of ICANN and losing registrar customers as a result of the bulk transfer. Now we will talk about the possibility number two. If Net for India does not cooperate with transition efforts or ICANN does not approve the proposed registrar in a voluntary bulk transfer case, ICANN may select a gaining registrar itself. In this case, due to limited availability of registration data, ICNN may allow Net for India to continue limited operations to be able to service existing customer needs, for example, renewals and updates, but not new domain name registrations, including other available options. Since transition of domain names from Net for India to another registrar depends on many factors, the selection of gaining registrar by ICANN may follow one of the two available processes. Process A, full competitive application process, and process B, a fast track process from a pre-qualified registrar pool. These processes differ on the basis of number of registrations involved, availability of reliable, unreliable, or incomplete data, etc. Although not preferable, but as an exception, transition of affected domain names to multiple registrars may also be a choice in the event no one registrar is operational in all affected TLDs or when it is impractical to complete the transition process in a single bulk transfer due to some other challenges. So this completes the latest update regarding Net for India. Depending on the processes involved in the termination of Net for India's registrar accreditation agreement with ICANN and assigning of a gaining registrar, it may take weeks to resolve your domain name related problems, but once it will start, you will have a reason to take a sigh of relief. Follow ICANN blog on Net4India. Don't ever trust on third-party mediators. Best of luck. Thank you for watching the video.